Hi, my name's Charles. Welcome to DrupalTutSurf.com. Now, in this video tour, I'm using you see this template is a Bootstrap template, and we have a view here. And what I'm going to show you is how to customize the display of this view for the teasers, and how to use that with, and by using the Bootstrap CSS, we can make it responsive. Now, first thing you need to do is log into your FTP. All you need to make a Bootstrap selfie. If you're not sure how to do that, I made a previous video tour how to do that, so you just watch that one. And once you watch that tool, you can follow on with this one. So I suggest you do that now if you haven't done that, or if you have done the how to make a Bootstrap selfie. Okay, so first thing we need to do, we're just going to visit our view. So we go edit view. Alright, first thing we need to do, we see where it says format, we need to change this to fill, so we just click on where it says content, and now we click on fills, and apply displays, then apply all. Okay, after we've done that, we need to add our three fills, so first we just go to add. We choose the content body and we just click apply, and we need to uncheck label, exclude from display, and we're just going to show you something. So at the moment we go to rewrite output of this field, click on replacement pattern, so we can see we got the title field and the body field. We want the image field too, so I'm just going to show you how we get the image field. We click on add, and then we find the image field, which is this one, content image. Click on apply. Then we uncheck create label and check exclude from display. And I'm going to leave image styles as is, but if you want to change the image style, this is where you do it. Link to image, we want to choose content, and then click apply. Okay, so we need to, next thing we need to do is we just go on, get the rearrange, drag the body field below, because only fields above the body were showing the rewrite results. So we just go click on apply, and now we're just going to go to our body field and just uncheck that shouldn't be checked, and just go to rewrite results. And we look here, I'll show you. So now we got the title field, the image field, and the body field. I'm just going to show you something. So if that image field was below the body field, so we're going to go to there, rearrange, and we're just going to drag the image field below the body field, and click on the body content field to see the rewrite results, and we just click on there, and we click on replacement patterns, and we can see there's no longer image field. That's because now the image field is below the body field. The one that rewrites results always has to be at the bottom. So just rearrange that again. Let's drag that body field at the bottom. Okay, so here we go. So the next thing we need to do, we've got the text field, body field shown here. Now we want to show the image and title field. So to do that, we just click on the content body, and we click on the replacement patterns. We find, and we just go copy these into here, and that will show. Okay, so I'll just show you how this works. Thank you. category. So now we should see our title, our image, and our body field showing up down here. So click apply. Okay, so we see our image, our title, and the body field. And just to show you that's working, so if we delete the image token, as it's called, so say let's delete this, click apply, and that will move, but now we only see the title and the body field. So yeah, we can only see the title and the body field now. So the next thing we want to do is add the Bootstrap style into these. Okay, so we go rewrite results, and we just gotta delete this. Now I've already done this just to save time. Okay, I'm just gonna copy this and see what I've done here. So we've got a wrapping div, which is this one for the teaser. And then we got within that we got a span, a Bootstrap span 4, so that'll go. This will go on the left, because it's on the first one on the top always goes left. And then we got a 6 span and a 6 span for the body too. And we just put the image field in there, the text field, text token there, and the body in there. Okay, so we click apply. Okay, and we'll have a look how that looks on the front end of our website. Okay, that's great. That's what I was expecting to see. So now we've got we need to add some extra classes to just refine this a bit. But basically if I just show you, so we get the developer tools. We can see we got the there we go, the div four span there. And we can see, just highlight correctly, yeah, div span 6 there, and for the body 2. Yeah, there, we got that there. And that's what we need to add, a clear float class to get this display underneath. Okay, so just got to get rid of those developer tools. Okay, so now we just go here and we just got to add some classes. So we just go back to our content body. And we go to our rewrite results. I'm going to add a wrap class for this one. Let's go class, and we go, let's call it teaser. Make sure we add the T. Teaser.wrap. Right, and then we're going to add a class for image. So, okay, so we're just going to call this image teaser. See what I do, I'll just copy that. Paste that in there, like so. Just place that with image. Okay, image. And we just click on the apply display. And right, so just beforehand, I'm just going to copy that, let's see. Let's go back to it, and we just go copy this. Okay, right. So, let's go back to our page, alright. Now, I've done a mistake here already, but I'll show you what's happened anyway. So, let's go with that. Okay, so first thing we want to do is go to make a clear class for this, so there, and we're just going to go clear.body. Okay, next thing, we just got to copy that. And we're just going to call image, and just going to do another image tag there. And I'm going to do margin bottom, so this is going to clear it. So margin dot bottom dot 20 pixels. Okay, so we just save that. And I'll go upload this, the style CSS, which we get from here, which is a Bootstrap subtheme style CSS. So just go upload that up there. Okay, and when I save this, so let's have a look, see what happens. Okay, refresh that. Okay, I know exactly why nothing's changed, because if we go to, and if you've done this too, I want to show you what happens. Okay, because all changes are still temporary, click here to save and make your changes permanent. So every time you do a change to the view, you need to save it to show those changes. I think it's good to show you the mistakes so you can see what happens if you come across that issue yourself. Okay, and now we've got how view looks. Now if I want to just make these titles, give them an H3 tag, all I have to is just go to edit view. We go to the body. We go to the rewrite results. So that's our image. Here's our title. We just add a H3 tag to this one. H3, apply. Okay, so save that. There you go, and you can see we've got the H3 tag here. Okay, I hope that's helpful. If you've got any questions, please leave a comment below, or please like this video, or subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can find more templates at Drupal TutSurf and tutorials there, so if you want to try some themes, you feel most welcome. Alright, take care, see you in the next video. Bye.